Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Syncfusion Angular Dialog component. Using the Dialog component, you can create a dialog box to collect input from users or inform them about errors, warnings, as well as confirm their decisions. You can also drag, resize, and position the Angular dialog. In this video, I will show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on any supported browser. First, I need to install the Angular CLI in my machine using this command, npm install -g at angular/cli. Since I have already installed the Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step. Next, I am going to create a new Angular project, so I use this command, ng new project name. I named my project Angular Dialog. This will create an Angular project and its dependencies. Now, I navigate to the project folder. To use the Syncfusion Angular Dialog, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular popups package and its dependencies using this command. npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-popups --save. Now, I am going to open the application in Visual Studio Code. The first thing I need to do is import the dialog module from the Syncfusion Angular popups package. Navigate to the app module file and import the dialog module from the Syncfusion ej2angular popups package. Register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion Angular license key in this Angular app. So, let me open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion ej2 base package. Then, I register the Syncfusion Angular trial license key by using the register license method. The Syncfusion Angular license key registration is required, starting with the 2022 Volume 1 release. Next, I make changes in the app component HTML file by replacing its default content with the Angular dialog code. Then, I set height and width properties with appropriate values to specify a custom height and width for the dialog component. Also, I need to define CSS for the dialog, so let me import the material theme in the style.css file. Along with this, I define a few CSS styles for the HTML and body element. I will save this application and run it using the command ng serve. Looking at the output page, the Angular dialog component is rendered. Next, I will show you how to add content and a header for the dialog component. To do that, I will add the properties content and header with appropriate values inside the Angular dialog code. You can see the dialog now displayed with header and content. Next, I will show how to add a button to the footer of the dialog. Here, I have planned to append a cancel button at the footer of the dialog. To do that, let me open the app component TS file. Then, I define an object dialog button and add the button model property. For this dialog button, I will set the content as cancel. Now, assign this object to the button's property of the dialog component. Look at the output page now. The dialog is displayed with the cancel button in the footer, but the dialog does not close after clicking the cancel button. Here, I need to write the code to close the dialog when the cancel button is clicked. First, I will add a click event with an appropriate handler inside the dialog button's object. Then, I will start to define the event handler hideDialog with emit type. Here, I need to import the emit type from the Syncfusion ej2 base package to access it. Now, I need to access the dialog component instance to hide the dialog, so I add a reference variable dialog component and access it using the view child directive within this app component TS file. Then, I define a variable dialog object of type dialog component to get the dialog instances. Also, I import the view child directive and dialog component class From Angular Core and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Popups package to access the child component instances. Then, I will make a call to the public method of the dialog hide, using this dialog reference instance to hide the dialog when the cancel button is clicked. And now, you can see the dialog closed when the cancel button is clicked. Suppose I want to close the dialog using close icon. Then, I need to define a Boolean variable, close icon, and set its value as true. Now, I will assign this variable to the show close icon property of the dialog component. You can see in the dialog component, the close icon is appended at the right corner of the dialog. When I click the icon, the dialog is closed. Here, if I want to open the dialog again, then I can use an HTML button component. First, I need to define button code with the class and style attributes. Here, I set the button content as open dialog. As I said before, I am going to display the dialog after the button is clicked. Therefore, I add a click event with the appropriate handler in the button component. Now, I am going to use the already defined dialog component instance. So, I will define the event handler on open dialog and call to the public method of the dialog show using this dialog reference instance to open the dialog when the open dialog button is clicked. You all know that initially the dialog will be visible. So, to hide the dialog, I define the Boolean variable dialog visibility as false and assign this variable to the visible property of the dialog component. Look at the output page now. The dialog is opened when the button is clicked. By default, the dialog is displayed in the center of the target container. If I want to change the dialog position, then I define the dialog position with the properties X and Y. For the X property, I can set the value to left, center, right, or any offset value. And for the Y property, the value can be top, center, bottom, or any offset value. I want to render the dialog at the top right, so I set the X value as right and the Y value as top. Now, assign this object to the position property of the dialog component. And now, you can see the dialog displayed at the top right of the output page. Next, I will show you how to drag and resize the dialog. To drag and resize the dialog, I will define the allow dragging and enable resize properties with the value true. Looking now, you can easily drag and resize the dialog. I want to resize the dialog in all directions, so I define a variable dialog resize directions of type resize direction and sets value as all. Here, I import the resize direction type from the Syncfusion popups package. Now, I assign this variable to the resize handles property. You can see in the dialog, you can resize the dialog in all directions. Finally, I will show you how to animate the dialog control. First, I need to define a variable dialog animation settings with the effect property. The Angular dialog control supports 16 different effects. I am going to flip the dialog content up, so I set the effect to flip X up. To set a custom duration, I will need to define the duration property with appropriate value. Now, I assign this object to the animation settings property. Here, I plan to position the dialog at the center of the output page, so let me set the X and Y properties value as center. Looking at the output page now, the dialog gets flipped in the upward direction. Notice here, I can interact with the output page when the dialog is opened. Suppose I want to restrict the interaction, then I can define the isModel property as true within this dialog code. And now, when the dialog is opened, it is not possible to interact with the page as an overlay is formed behind the dialog. In this video, we saw how to create an Angular CLI project using Visual Studio Code and how to add the Syncfusion Angular Dialog component to it. We also saw how to drag, resize, and position the dialog, as well as how to create an overlay behind the dialog and render the dialog using an HTML button element. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.